like you and me ought to have a little talk.
We have got more things to talk about. Well, Mr. Hackett, well, nothing. I don't know what I told you. You didn't pull me up your skirt. Being skinny enough to be a snake, too little to be a man, and too big to be a mouse. I'm resting. Good. Answer me one question. Do you really love us? Because if I thought you didn't, I'd tie you up in a bag and chuck you in the river. Are you serious about her?
Yes, I'm serious.
And do you worship the ground that she walks on? Like I do? Hacking, this is the one answer that's better than yet.
Yes.
What the hell are you doing? Yes. Can you tell me every stain you had for her? That's what I did, clean up bag. Full of presents. Cost $50.
If you had that $50 cash.
I'll have ate your Annie and you'd lose her.
Yes,
I blew some.
Let's take a look what you've got in there. I might want to try something.
Well, what do you want, Linda?
I'm a peddler, aren't I? I buy and I sell. Pay you real money? Maybe as much as... well, a lot. What a beautiful water bag. Looks fresh. Must have cost plenty. I'll give you... $8 for
you. $8?
No, I wouldn't be earning. And you paid $3.50.
I said I'll give you $8, and I will. Now. Say, that's a cracker, Jake.
Take your hands off of that. That was for a women night.
It don't fit you so good. I'll give you $22 for it. All right, $22.50, but not a cent more. What a beautiful item, Grace.
There? Though? That was for her to wear.
I didn't hardly think they were for you. I'll give you $15 for it next. Now let's see. 8 and 22 is 30, and 15 is 45, 50 cents is 45.50.
45.50. Say, that's almost... yes. You want to buy some more?
No, I don't mind.
Can you see one of these?
What's the matter? Put it in for some of it?
What do you mean?
Just for the picture.
Is that all you think it is? Well, it's more than that. It's what you might call kind of... But where's your money?
Right here in my hand.
That ain't yours. You just bid it, didn't you? You just give it to the schoolhouse. Still gotta say, Fred's still getting the daughter's hand.
Wait a minute. That ain't fair.
Go for $50. Go, hickey ball.
Just as reckless as Curly McLean, I guess. Just as good as getting what I want.
Going for everything I got. Everything I've taken 2 years doing farm work. All for love. Here it is. $42.31.
Anybody want to buy a gun? You slim?
Buy a brand new last night, human. Worth a lot.
Hey, don't say that, Joe.
You ain't out for it.
Okay. And Heather, I'm going to make my bid $53.
Stop having fun. I mean, with other fellas.
think you slap that whip on old Eddie and then make her run away. What was your hurry?
I'm afraid we'd be late for the party.
You didn't want to be with me by yourself. Not a minute more than you had to.
Why, I don't know what you're talking about. I'm by myself now, ain't I?
You wouldn't have been if you could have got out of it. What if you stay in your room all the time? Not if you stay in the front room, won't get out of the sight. Last time I see you alone, it was winter. And the snow was 6 feet deep and drenched when I was sick. You brought me that hot soup out of the smokehouse and give it to me. Me in bed. I ain't shaved in 2 days. You asked me if I had fever. You put your hand on my head, see?
Yeah, I remember.
Do you? But you don't remember as much as me. I remember everything you ever done. Every word you ever said. Can't think of nothing. See how it is?
Yeah!
Ain't good enough, am I? I'm a hired hand, I got dirt in my hands, big fuck. Ain't fit to touch you. You're better. So much better. Yeah, we'll see who's better, Mr. Barry. And then you'll wish you were so clear headed. Such a fine lady.
Are you making threats to me? Are you standing there trying to tell me if I don't want you to swallow me like a hawk? Why, you're going to do something about it. You're nothing but a man's dog. Somebody ought to shoot you. So much about being a hot hand. Well, I'll tell you something and rest your brain, Mr. Jeff. When hard not to me no more, you hear? You can just pack your dust and scoot. Oh, and while I'm at it, I got even better ideas than that. Better come on this place again, you hear me? I'll send your stuff any place you say. But you just mush that foot inside that patch again, and I'll send the dogs on to you.
Said you say. Brought it on yourself. Can't help it. I never asked. Told you the way it was. You wouldn't listen. Annie!
Hey, yo, Annie!
Who's that?
It's me, Laurie. You seen Annie?
Well?
Don't care.
Well, did you do something for me? Don't find Curly and tell him up here. I want to see Curly!
Why don't you turn around and look at crazy woman?
Curly!
If I'm yours, I'm going to go hunt for mine. Now, what on earth is they in a better plan for? I come if you ain't crying. Chunking toasters.
Don't you leave me.
Quick, God Almighty.
No, let me cry. I can't help.
Oh, cry your eyes out.
I don't know what to do.
Yeah, I'll
show you. Oh, that old man can stand in public. Get away from me, you. Like you? My God, get away from me, I tell you. Plum away from me.
How are you going to tell me why?
Oh, it's cold and hungry likes.
You should burn a hole in your pants.
You do, do you?
You hear me.
Laura, now look here. You stand over here, right where you are, and I'll sit over here. And you tell me what you want me to do.
Well, Jasmine. Annie, he's crazy. Never saw nobody like him before. He talked loud and he cut me so
much.
I wish I had this and I don't tell him what I do now.
Sorry. Well then, that's all there is to it. Tomorrow I'll get a new hard hat. I'll stand on the place myself tonight and worry about that hound dog. Now quit your worrying or I'll spank you. Hey, what a thing to it. How's about marriage?
Gracious. What I wouldn't marry you for?
Well, can you maybe think of some reason why you might?
I can't think of nothing right now. Hardly.
Oh, Laura, please, man. Marry me. I don't know what I'm going to do if you don't.
Why, Curly, I'll marry you if you want me to.
happiest man alive as soon as he married. Well, I gotta learn to be a farmer, I see that. Quit thinking about throwing the rope and getting your hands blistered in a new way. Oh, things are changing right and left. Buy up mowing machines, cut down the prairies, shoe your horses and drag them plows out of the sod. They're gonna make a state out of this country. They're gonna call it Oklahoma. Oh, things are changing right and left. Gotta change with it. Bring a pair of boys. New stuff. Keep the things the way they're going around here in this crazy country. And now I've got you to marry me. I'm not to something yet. Oh, I remember the first time I ever saw you. It was at the fair. You was riding that great Billy Blue Stars. And I says to someone, who's that skinny little thing and a bag hanging down her forehead?
Yes, I remember. You was riding road coat that day.
That's right.
Yeah. I wasn't in the Trojan.
That's right. They're not for me!
Yes, you
don't talk
about
it. Sure. I don't
know. Yes, you sure did.
Goodbye, my baby. Friend of the family. Lucky fellow. I wish it was me she was marrying instead of you.
Don't see you make an awful lot of difference.
Oh well, back to the open road, the lonely gypsy. One goodbye is never enough.
We ain't gonna think of old Panda no more, are you?
Course not. Now quick, not one last thing, wasn't I?
I'll never leave your side.
Even if you don't.
Take this here woman.
I scared it wouldn't say it.
I was afraid to turn back out on me.
I saw the moonlight gleaming off the barrel of our father's shotgun. I thought it would be better to be alive. But now I ain't so sure.
Now he ain't gonna travel around the country no more. I decided he ought to settle down in Bushyhead and help from the pop store. Hi, Whale. Did you hear the news? You're already married to Poplar.
Mighty glad to hear that, Peddle Man. Think I ought to kiss the bride, friend of the family. Hey, Judy. You haven't Oklahoma hello. Hello, Gertie.
Get out of here, boy! Yeah.
Corrie on here. She's fair to Marcia, you know? And he thinks I ought to give myself up. Tonight.
No. Why, he trained me for car barn. Wait a minute.
Best thing is for Curly to go his own accord and tell the judge.
Why, you're the judge, ain't you, Andrew?
That's right.
But tell him now and get it over with.
It wouldn't be proper. You have to do it in court.
Well, let's do it here and then we did it in court.
We can't do that. That's breaking the law.
Well, let's not break the law. Let's just ban it.
wholehearted congratulations.
Thank you.
Well, Mr. Frank McGreevy, he's not here tonight, is he?
Appreciation is most welcome here all the time, and I